soca people, because I really want to make work with this evening. No, we're not dealing with the people, but kind of like soca.
The thing is, sometimes you have to encourage persons to actually have fun. Yeah, believe it or not, you actually have to encourage them or let them know that it's okay to let go and have fun. So my job is to really just, you know, ad lib along with the songs, along with the music, say the right things, try to get a vibe and build up and stuff. That's my job. And, you know, well, the DJs are doing a great job regardless, but I think I'm supposed to just add a little, to it.
The taxi man, them say one already, two and drive. Right now,
it started like way back on campus because I took a long break. Way back on campus, I was just actually playing around and thing with it, and you know, apparently I had a knack for it, so it continued and I continued for a bit, and then I stopped for a long period. Like the only time I really did it was when we like popped into Barbados, you know, for a carnival or so. I would just, you know, play around, and apparently, I, like I said, I have a knack for it. So then I decided a couple of years ago to actually take it a little bit more serious, and well, the rest is history. Wow, which parties have I done? It's probably a shorter list of the list what I have not done. But a lot of it is soca. A lot of it is soca. I've done I Love Soca. I've done Soca Forever, Soca Therapy. I've done Bacchanal, Rum for Breakfast, Rum for Christmas. I've done a lot of the Jamaica things, the Jamaica pop-ups, Jamaica Harbor Jam. I've been on the road since Jamaica started also. Whoa. Like I said, it's probably a shorter list to say what I have not done in the soca market. Toca Loco, etc. Fet Republic's Night Carnival, Fet Republic's Halloween. Basically, yeah, you know, Heineken Rio. It's a long list. Done Tribe, I've done a float. I probably should have done Moonlight. I probably should just go through the carnival week, and yeah, so I've basically done most of the events that happen in the soca week and thing, Rock the Boat, etc. Marmana and thing. Yeah, everything. Basically. There are many a persons who this is their job. You know, this is their job, and a good MC is like, especially like in the Jamaican soca market, there are very few of us who actually can do it. So outside of me and Brush One and Cyclone and so forth and Jar, there are very few persons who really understand how to balance it and to actually bring an energy to it and not overpower it. Because soca is not the same sort of energy as dancehall, you know, so it's knowing how to bring it and how to relate right across the board.
Soca Cyclone! There is no behavior. This is Jamaica. No matter what we adjust, don't cross the border.
What makes me the life of the party? I think it's the energy that I bring also. Like I said, soca and dancehall emceeing is kind of different, right? And in this market especially, I know most of the, a lot of the persons. I know the persons who are staples in the market, so I can actually talk to them, I can relate to them, you know, I will actually, you know, pick them out and single them out and say whatever. So I genuinely love soca, and I genuinely have that sort of energy, so it's just really for me to translate to the rest of the audience. And most of them, you know, when soca parties, people come here to party. They're here, they want to have fun. You might have to encourage them a little bit, but that's it. So that's what makes me the life of the party.